Good morning, children. Hope you all are fine. This is Grade 3 Science Class. We are doing Block 25 Natural Disasters. So, in that, in the previous class, we have learned one of the natural disasters, causes, effects, and safety measures to prevent it. Now, today we are going to learn the one more natural disasters about drought in second subtopic S2 children. So, the floods, we have learned the causes of floods are due to a heavy rainfall. But the drought is a condition which happens when there is no rainfall for a long time. And drought happens when there is too little rainfall in the areas and when there is a very less rainfall and the temperatures in that areas are very too hot. And when they are, the temperatures are very high in the regions, which leads to a less rainfall and drying up everything, splits happens on the earth surface. That leads to a drought conditions. This is a one more natural disasters which happens due to the very less rainfall. Let us learn the causes, effects and safety measures to prevent it. Here, what are the causes of drought condition when there is very less rainfall in the areas? Leads to a drought condition. And when there is, the temperatures are too hot in these regions, when the regions which are very too hot, what happens? The water bodies will, they get dried up and then we cannot see any of the plants growing up there. And the sources of water, when the temperatures are too hot, what happens? The water will dry up, the water will evaporate, and then due to the cutting of trees, the drought condition even causes due to the cutting of trees. So how it happens? When we cut off trees, there will be no rainfall occurs. So when there is no rainfall, no trees are there, if we are cutting off all the trees, when there is no rainfall for a long time, so what happens? There will be no water for any of the use. So it leads to a drought condition. So these are the major causes of drought natural disasters. Less rainfall or low rainfall and too hot, and the sources of water dries up and even cutting of trees. These are the major causes of the drought condition. And what are the effects of it? How it affects us? When there is no water, will we get water for drinking or any other purposes? We will not have any of the water for any of the use. And if, because all the water bodies will dry up, all the sources of water will get dries up. So we will not have any water for any of the use. And the land dries up. We can see the land will completely dries up. When there is a rainfall, proper rainfall, we can see the moisture content in the water. But when there is no rainfall, very less rainfall, the land will completely seen as drying up. And plants, animals and people will die. So we need water for many of our uses. So when the plants do not get water, they cannot give any food for the animals and the people. So we cannot get food from the plants. The plants need water for growing. So when there is no water for plants, they cannot give food for animals and the people. So what happens? We will die. And when there is no water for the plants, no food for the plants, no food for the animals, and no food for the people. So all will die. And no food for any of the living things. So these are the effects and how we are going to prevent. So already I said the natural disasters cannot be prevented completely, but we can follow some of the safety measures to prevent it. So what are the safety measures? Look at here. Safety measures: use water wisely and properly. So when there is a less rainfall, when there is very little rainfall occurring, so how we have to use? We should not waste water. We should see that water should be used very wisely and properly, so that you can save it for some of the uses. So wait for relief measures from government. So what the government people will do, they will provide food and water, and they also help us in getting supply of water for the future. So they will plan us for getting supply of water in that region and to not face the drought condition again. So in that way they will help us by providing the supply of water in that region. And how are these floods and drought condition is different, children? The floods happen when there is a heavy rainfall, and the drought condition happens when there is less rainfall. So this is the major difference from the two natural disasters, floods and drought. So in both the conditions, due to the cutting of the trees, when it imbalances the nature, these natural disasters we are facing. So avoid, stop cutting the trees, so that if you cut the trees, it will stop the rainfall. So if you plant more and more trees, it will balance the nature and we will not able to face these natural disasters for the future. We can be prevented by these natural disasters. So the major causes, if you follow some of the safety measures, we will not fall under this. We are not going to face these natural disasters. And even you are not going to waste the water. Even if you are not in a drought condition, use the water properly. Do not waste the water. When you are not using the taps, you are going to off the taps and use the water wisely and properly so that you can save it for the future uses. Okay, children. Now let us learn from. Children, open your reader, page number 155. Drought. Droughts happen when there is no rain for a long time and rivers and streams dry up. Droughts can also happen when the sources of water dry up. Cutting down trees is the main cause of droughts. In a drought, the land dries up completely and the plants die. People and animals do not get food and sometimes die of hunger. So in this picture you can see the condition of drought, children, here. So without the water, how the splits happen on the earth surface. So this is a drought condition. Read the lesson and underline drought, rivers, streams and hunger as keywords. Now take out practice questions, children. Take out practice questions, page number 158. Today you are going to complete third and fourth. How is a drought different from a flood? So how is the drought different from a flood? Flood So from here to here you write, make two columns, flood and drought, and write in the flood column, you write, floods happen when water from nearby water bodies flows into the land. Now drought, what you will write? Droughts happen when there is no rain for a long time and rivers and streams dry up. So you can write these points and you can add any of the points by reading the lesson. Now see the next question. How can you help people in drought areas? So how you will help the people in drought areas? By providing them food and water. So you can help the people in drought areas by providing them food and water. Now take out your workbooks, children. Open your workbook, page number 46. Look at the two pictures given, picture A and picture B. If you clearly observe, you can see that the picture B doesn't show the plants. They have been dried up. Here you can see some of the trees, but here everything got dried up due to drought condition. So here is an article, March 2013, the drought in Maharashtra is causing farmers to cut their crop and dig deeper in search of water. Little rainfall is the main cause for drought. Too much cutting of trees is also one of the main reason for drought to occur. And people and cattle are not getting water to drink and food to eat. People are falling sick and some are dying of hunger. Some people are leaving their villages and moving to other towns or villages in search of water and food. So the drought in Maharashtra causing farmers to cut their crops and dig deeper in search of water. They are digging that deeper so that they can get some water. But due to the little rainfall, there was no water. It was a complete drought condition there. So too much cutting of trees is the one of the main reason for the droughts to occur. And the people, even the cattle, are not getting water to drink and food to eat. So the people are falling sick and some are dying of hunger when the plants doesn't grow. Even animals are not giving any of the food. So the people are dying of hunger. We are not getting any of the foods. Some people are leaving their villages. So what they are doing? They are leaving that place and migrating to the other places where the water facility is good. So some people are leaving their villages and moving to other towns or villages in search of water and food. This is an article, children. So from this you are going to write what are the two effects of the drought. Write two effects of drought. The crops and plants die because of lack of water. So due to the drought condition, the crops and plants will die due to the lack of water. Even we find it difficult to get water to drink and even to do other activities. For the many of our activities are linked up with the water. So we need water for many of our works. So when we don't get water for drinking and other activities, everything will get stopped. See the second one, what can people affected by drought do? So the people who are affected by drought, what that people will do? Use water carefully and stay indoors, avoid direct sunlight. So if you stay indoors, even use water carefully and avoid direct sunlight, you can save yourself. And see the third one, what can we do to prevent droughts from occurring? The cutting of trees is the main cause of drought. So we can avoid cutting of trees. If you avoid cutting of trees, we can prevent the drought condition. So in this way, complete your works, read the lesson, children, and do your works.